When the news came out that Vermont U.S. Senator Patrick Leahy was taken to the hospital on Tuesday night, there were gasps in Washington. Leahy's spokesman said he was only taken to the hospital out of an abundance of caution, and that he returned home hours later. He was seen back at work on Wednesday morning, almost like it never happened. Just hours before going to the hospital, Leahy had been sworn in to oversee the second impeachment trial of Donald J. Trump, set to begin in days. While it increasingly looks like Trump will not be convicted of the single impeachment article, there were some logistical questions about how this would even work if Leahy had been somehow unavailable to be in the Senate. But to be concerned about the impeachment trial is missing what should be a much larger and alarming point for Democrats. It should, instead, be a reminder of just how fragile of status the Democratic control is right now. After all, the only reason Democrats control the 50-50 bipartisan split in the Senate is because of Vice President Kamala Harris can break a tie. Should one Democrat face a sudden scandal and resign, then poof goes the Democratic majority. The same with someone who has a sudden death, debilitating health challenges, or, gasp, switches parties. Leahy's health scare is a cautionary tale. He says he got a clean bill of health, but should the 80-year-old and the longest-serving Senate Democrat vacate his seat for whatever reason, it would be up Vermont Governor Phil Scott, a Republican, to name a replacement. And there are 23 other senators who come from states with a governor in the opposing party. And get this, 7 of them are in New England, a majority of the dozen senators from the region. Back when Senator Bernie Sanders was running for president, Scott, a moderate, pledged that should Sanders become president, he would replace him with a Democrat. But that was then. This time around, there would be tremendous pressure for Scott to appoint a Republican and tip the scales back to Republican control. In fact, there would be no better way for Republicans to retain the seat than for Scott to appoint himself, given his popularity is so strong that he won re-election in the fall with 68% of the vote. To be clear, any senator that an opposing party governor names would only serve in office until a special election can be held. But that means potentially presidency-defining months for Biden might be in the hands of Republican Mitch McConnell when it comes to the Senate. For now, Leahy appears to be fine health-wise, and no senators appear close to changing parties or resigning. But the very tight majority is one reason why Senators Elizabeth Warren or Sanders were never really an option to join Biden's administration. Going forward, the status both politically and health-wise for every individual senator should be closely monitored. There is no margin for error. James Pindle can be reached at james.pindle@globe.com.